an undergraduate student in Dr. Aldrich's 332 Environmental Physiology class, and today I'd like to talk a little bit about some common environmental estrogens of beef cattle. But before I begin, what is an environmental estrogen, and why do we as producers and animal scientists care? So an environmental estrogen is also known as a xeno or phytoestrogen. It is a food, plant, or chemical substance that mimics the action of an estrogen by binding to cell receptors in the body. Consequently, this alters hormonal activity and, if exposed to in large amounts, can permanently damage the reproductive system of the animal. And so here we have a picture of these cell receptors binding, of these estrogens binding to the cell receptors in the body, and it's sending an unintended signal. So, before I begin on some common environmental estrogens, I'd like to talk about the normal heat cycle of a cow. So, it is 21 days in length and contains a 15 to 18 hour period of standing heat. At this time, the cow will either be covered by a bull, artificially inseminated, implanted with an embryo, or not bred at all and allowed to come out of heat. There are many factors that can affect a cow's heat cycle and make it particularly difficult to detect estrus or for her to ovulate at all. She will also exhibit a bloody discharge 2 to 3 days after breeding. This picture depicts a cow in standing heat. Environmental or internal factors that are not necessarily estrogenic in nature but still can affect estrus include what cycle stage the cow's herd mates are in, how thin or fat the cow is, so a body condition score, the type of footing the cow is housed on. This will affect heat detection because cows that are housed on slippery surfaces will not mount other cows. Days since the cow last calved, and nutritional composition of the cow's feed. If you suspect environmental estrogen problems, these may be some factors you'd like to check first. Now let's review some basic and common environmental estrogens. Zearalenone is the first. It's a mycotoxin, meaning that it is produced as a byproduct of a fungus. Zearalenone causes decreased fertility, milk production, abnormal estrus cycles, and abortions when consumed in very small amounts. It can be found in corn, barley, oats, wheat, rice, and sorghum, and it is produced by the fungus Fusarium roseum. Another fairly common environmental estrogen is red clover, a member of the legume family and fed for its high protein content. Effects of red clover include reduced fertility, uterine prolapse, and dystocia, or problems giving birth. Red clover is not safe to feed at more than 25% of the total diet to lactating, gestating, or cycling animals meant to be bred. It also negatively affects stressed individuals more frequently. An environmental estrogen that can contaminate drinking water sources is BPA or bisphenol A. It is a compound found in almost all hard plastics that causes decreased ovarian follicular development. BPA can contaminate creeks, rivers, and ponds in cow pastures. Discarded plastics that are exposed to sunlight emit BPA that is then carried into water. This environmental estrogen is a big problem for cows that are housed on bigger pastures with natural drinking. The last environmental estrogen I will be going over is a commonly used insecticide called DDT. It is a member of the organochlorine family and has been sprayed on forages and animals to keep insects at bay since 1939. DDT is colorless, odorless, and tasteless, so toxicity can occur undetected very easily. DDT most often affects animals that are kept near or on crop fields and causes decreased milk production and even respiratory issues. So what can we do if we are aware that our animals are acting differently, are having abnormal estrus cycles, or decreased fertility? If you suspect your animal's fertility is being harmed by an environmental estrogen, there are certain steps that can be taken. Have your veterinarian test your grain, forage, and water sources for contamination, and talk to them about the origins such as air quality, as origins of pollution. If environmental estrogens are detected, removal of the feed or water substance is highly suggested, and an examination of the affected cow should be done to determine just how much their reproductive systems have been affected. I hope that this presentation has helped you understand a little bit more about what environmental estrogens are and how they can affect breeding stock performance. Thank you for your time, and be sure to check out these links in order to learn even more about environmental estrogens of beef cattle.
Oh, yeah, wow. Talk about setting the bar high.